You know, the one thing I love about Vegas Live with Ninon is the direction I get from Steve. And Steve, you know, working with him over the years and the months and everything, it's funny how you have that attachment where he can say, do Ninon do this? And I say, should I do this? And it's absolutely amazing attachment. I have back with me Sophia Stewart. And actually, you were on a couple of weeks ago. But yes. This Matrix thing, we didn't really get into this new movie. I think it's called Matrix 4.
Yes.
Am I on right? Am I there?
You are there.
I'm right there.
Correct.
And apparently this is going to be animated. And the reason of the animation is because COVID-19. So.
Yes.
So you turned it around. I would think that would be a very difficult movie to be animated.
Animation would be actually, because you could do live and animation together.
Yes.
And it would be great because with COVID-19, it's very difficult to bring the kind of special effects and graphics that are going to be in Matrix 4. See, yes. The book has been out since 2010, selling globally around the world.
Yes.
It's more Matrix. It actually began where the third Matrix, Reloaded, Revolution is the third one.
Yes.
Well, I made Reloaded and Revolution a dream. So Neo and Trinity and Morpheus never died.
Okay.
They shared.
Well, they have because they're going to do the next movie.
That's right.
You can't. If you die, you're gone.
That's right. But they share a dream together, especially Neo and Trinity. They share a dream together and they wake up and the saga of the Matrix continue, but more is greater with greater special effects and graphics.
You started this. When did you write the first one?
I wrote the first one, the first Matrix, yes. And won 4 Oscars. It's a combination of the Matrix and Terminator together. In other words, the Terminator is the prequel, so
yes.
The beginning of
Which
the epic story. That's
yeah.
Right, with Schwarzenegger. And in fact, he called me about the Terminator,
okay.
You know what I'm saying, because he loved it.
Yeah.
And so it's
because surely he would, you know.
Oh yeah, made him a big star, made him super rich, super famous, you know,
yeah,
put him right where he wanted to be in the movie world. But anyway, Terminator End Time Revelations is the prequels, because what happens is, in the future, the machines hear the Oracle's prophecy that a baby is going to be born that's going to destroy them when they enslave mankind in the future.
Is this a very up-to-date kind of thing that's kind of going on in regular life?
Well, it's science.
Sounds
it's
like a little bit.
It's
yeah, science
fiction.
But it's also a lot of stuff in there that's kind of, I'm
prophecy.
Not sure what we're going through, but what it's like, you know, just think a little deeper. Think a little deeper of what's in your mind. And Sophia, how does this happen that you see this thing in the future? Because it's the future.
That's right. That's correct. I'm a seer.
Yeah, but you're actually, a lot of people say they are, hearsay, but you actually write it down and it's actually there.
Yes, I did. A book and a script.
So she really does see the future.
Yes. And
hang on a second. Is my future going to be okay?
Your future is going to be fabulous, and I am serious when I say that. You're going to blow up even greater because of this COVID-19. You have a very exciting show, and a lot of people are starting to notice that even more and more because it's going out, streaming outward.
And that's because of you.
Well, no.
It's because of you, Sophia, because Sophia puts it out there. And if you don't put it out there, people don't know. But when it comes from your voice, from who you are, what you write, and what you have, they'll listen to you.
Yes.
Whereas other people, they might not listen to as much. I'm not saying they're not going to listen, but they listen to you because you're successful. And they know
you.
What you are. But you absolutely fascinate me when you see, because I see this a lot. I am saved from so many things because I know not to go there because I maybe listen to whatever I'm listening to or I don't know. So I don't do that. So I'm kind of saved. So I understand a little bit of what you do.
Yeah, well, you can see you have the gift yourself. You have the gift of sight. And this is why you're able to control your whole element of a show here and to make it so successful is because you can determine how comfortable or uncomfortable your guests are, what you can bring out of them.
I can bring anything out of them.
Yes, exactly. And they feel very, very comfortable with you.
I hope so.
Because they can feel the honesty that's coming out of you.
It's like I just had Joey Cortez on. You know, he's the referee, the fighter. And his wife. Now, obviously, his wife isn't kind of in the same picture as he's in. So I can talk all day long with him, and I'm going to let her sit there? No. So I try to bring her into the conversation to make her feel comfortable, to make her feel part of what's going on. They've been married for 60 years.
Wow.
I mean,
that is
50 insane. Years or something, but it's a long time.
Yes.
But you're absolutely right. But you do it even more because you're bringing out, you're writing these books of the future, and it truly is the future.
Oh, yes. I am talking in 1980. About digital downloading. I'm talking about barcodes, computerized warfare with drones. I'm talking about body scanners, food scanners, and anybody can go and pull up my work from the Library of Congress, the book and the script, and see all this technology that I wrote in 1980 while I was at USC
Film School. And that's
when
everything was, that was when everything was kind of starting, wasn't it?
That's right, it was the beginning.
The beginning of all these, when we had the great big phone, remember we had the great big phone?
That's right, because IBM didn't, and Xerox did not know what a mouse meaning the internet.
Yes.
They didn't know what a mouse was, the internet. And so Apple and Microsoft with Bill Gates and Steve Jobs with Apple became the billion-dollar, trillion-dollar babies.
Because everybody was interested in it. Everybody wanted to follow through with it. It wasn't a matter of it really getting out there. It was the inquisitive mind of everybody out there. What is this?
Yeah,
I've got to have it.
They knew about the internet was going to explode. And look at all of these billionaires like Jeff Bezos with Amazon, you see, and Google's Mongol, you know what I'm talking about?
Do you think there's too many rich, there's more billionaires, trillionaires now, I guess you call them.
That's right, you're going in that arena.
Do you think they're too many? Because now we're going to get an imbalance of, we used to have millionaires, not trillionaires, millionaires, billionaires, and we used to have a few of them. Now we've got a lot of them. But then that takes the balance away from the people that don't have anything. How do we?
Yeah, but they have to give. Like Tony Robbins say, the whole key to living is giving.
Yeah, but not everybody does that.
So they have to give. No, now listen, they do give now.
Yeah, okay.
And they give because they know the law. They know this law.
The law of attraction.
That's right. They know the law, and they know that if they do not give, they can't get any write-offs on taxes.
Well, that is very true, and that's why a lot of the big companies opened up their own foundations. You know, a lot of big companies have their in-house foundations so they can put everything through there.
Microsoft is one with Bill Gates and Linda, their foundation.
Yes, yeah.
So they have no choice.
What do you think of Linda Gates and Bill Gates as two people out there? The word going out, they've got mixed things are going out. Some are good, some are bad. What?
Well, I'm going to talk about their foundations of giving.
Yes.
I love the part that they have that foundation and that they're giving to people because they got billions of dollars that they have to give away.
Yeah.
And the more you help people, no matter if you do something bad, everything has to be balanced out.
You have to have the balance.
You've got to have the balance.
How do you balance yourself with the knowledge you have of what's happening in the future? How do you manage to?
I manage to balance out by mentoring and healing and helping. You know,
talking to other people.
That's right. Lots of people come to me. Remember when I was talking to you earlier about the water regimen?
Yes.
And then there's a special angel prayer that I give out while I'm doing my interviews and on my website. And this water regimen, it heals everything, under all the underlying health issues you may have. And it's something so simple, doesn't cost anything.
But I got to tell you something really funny. You're gonna crack up with this one. Okay, so I go to my bathroom. I have to take a thyroid pill, and then I take a acid pill, and then I take a B12. So I'm not a pill taker, actually. So I turn the tap on, it's warm water, and I think, oh, I can't wait for this water to go cold. So I'm drinking warm water, not knowing what it's doing to my system.
Cold water is really bad for
you. Bad for you, yes. We don't have cold water
for you.
In England.
It closes veins. It gives you a heart attack. It is horrible. It's unnatural.
Yeah, I don't like cold stuff. I never do because I come from England. We don't
Yeah,
we don't
you
really
guys always was drinking hot tea.
Yeah, well, I drink hot tea all the time.
Yes, well.
I mean, I have 4 or 5 cups of tea a day.
That's right. Well, the Asians, they drink the hot water because the Japanese doctor is telling people that if you drink the tea kettle heated water, it's just distilled water that scrubs out your large intestinal and your small one because that's where diseases.
Listen to this. Listen to
this
what you're
where
saying.
Diseases are formed.
So you've got to kill the disease, get it out of your
that's
system.
That's right. It will flush all the diseases and bad things and toxin and poison and metal and waste and parasites out of your body.
You might not understand this because you might think, I'm pure, I don't have anything in me. Everybody has these parasites and all this stuff within them because we eat food. We don't quite know where it all comes from, but if you know like little tiny insects that could be something you can't even see is in that. Now, they get stuck in your system.
That's right.
So if you drain your system out, do it with Sanity. I don't know if you know what Sanity is actually, it's incredible to take. Take it hot, but make sure you're going to be home for at least a day.
I'm going to tell you something that's going to blow your mind. In the womb, the word womb is matrix. Matrix is a 7,000-year-old Latin word for the woman's womb. Inside of the womb, you were born in the hot, heated water of your mother's womb. You grew, your body grew for 9 months, 36 weeks, and you were healthy, and you were swimming like a little fish with gills. And the warm water in the womb
kept
you nourished. It kept you healthy. So you don't need to put no lemon. You don't need to put no tea. You don't need to put
anything,
but just natural heated water. And it has the effect of the womb.
Now, can that water come out of the tap? Because when you boil a water...
It is not distilled water.
It's not distilled water.
Because distilled water is just like you're doing a radiation flush in your car. You want to flush out all the deposits,
everything.
You want to scrub it out.
Yep.
Well, the distilled water does that because it's heated by the tea kettle.
So you've got to get distilled water.
That's
tea
right.
Kettle.
And
English tea kettle. Everybody has one. I have one.
Or you can use your pot if
anything,
you don't have a
matter.
Tea kettle.
Doesn't
as long
matter.
As you can boil
can
it
they,
water.
Can they put it in the microwave oven?
No. Microwave changes the whole chemistry of everything, no matter what goes in that microwave. Microwave is like sending shockwaves or chemicals and changes the whole paradigm of anything that goes in there. Okay. No, you want to have tea kettle heated water.
The old English way.
That's right, the old English way.
The old English way of doing it.
And you want 16 ounces. 16 ounces of heated tea kettle water. Drink it down and wait 45 minutes before you eat. Look at the time. 45 minutes before you eat.
All right, so you've just got a great message. Get distilled water.
No, don't get distilled water. Just heat it up. The water with the tea kettle, it becomes
distilled
water.
Yeah, okay, becomes distilled. So any water.
That's right. You want to, but people want to use the best water that they got, it filtered water.
Whatever water you have.
Yeah, Kangen water, whatever water.
Use it, boil it, and drink it. I mean, don't burn yourself, but wait till
it's right. Just like you're drinking your tea or your coffee.
Anything hot. And then wait 45 minutes, then you can eat.
That's right. And then you can eat. And guess what? It is going to get rid of, it's going to flush your
body
out.
And nothing like feeling, you know, there's nothing like having a clean body inside.
Oh, yes.
We have a clean body outside. Well, I hope you do. I mean, you never know. You've got to take a shower once a day at least.
Okay. But it'll get rid of a lot of underlining health issues.
Well, things you don't know you have, because everybody thinks, well, I don't eat those foods and I wouldn't get it and I don't have that. That's not true. Every single person has it. Somebody maintain them more than others because of the way they eat and how they conduct their
lives.
That's
right. And a lot of people are surprised because they have heart attacks. They have diabetes that they don't know.
Look at the
type 1,
Sophia's lost weight within the last 2 weeks.
Oh, yes. Yes, I've lost 60 pounds, but not just gradually.
Gradually.
Yeah, but I'm still losing because I practice it every day.
Does it make you feel good? Does it feel better? Do you feel like, you know?
I feel great.
She can really get those matrix out. She can really start working on the matrix.
Yes.
Because her mind is now clear. Everything,
yes.
And you're feeling good about yourself.
And your skin is beautiful.
Well, you have beautiful skin
your
anyway.
Skin
so
will,
you're gorgeous.
Your skin will be glowing. You'll look 20. You'll look 20 years younger with this heated water, and you'll have the most incredible energy. I'm serious. I cannot wait to hear testimonies.
I bet you can.
Because I've put a lot of people on it.
Absolutely.
And they look glowing and losing the weight.
Was this something that you kind of saw in the future of yourself, as of doing this, thinking, you know, if I do this, I'm going because of the way you think. Of, you know, I'm going to make this going to feel better, and it's going to take time, but I'm sticking to it, I'm going to do it. Does this make you, do you feel that your mind is working even more than what it worked before?
Well, this is the deal. I got a degree in journalism, a double major in law and psychology. I studied to be a doctor, and I also studied the anatomy of the body. So when I saw the Japanese doctor talking about this warm water regimen, you know, the heated warm water regimen. I knew what he was talking about because I studied to be a doctor, so I knew that this would work.
Yes.
Because I had tried to lose weight, I had tried, you know, exercising, walking, all kinds of stuff. Nothing really worked.
You'd lose a few pounds and then you gain it back again. You know, that's the problem. Then everybody loses the enthusiasm of even ever going on a diet again. You know, they don't want to do that.
But everything fit into place once I did the warm water regimen with the tea kettle. It was a piece of cake. I didn't have to put anything with just
in it, nothing, water,
just what God has given us, water.
Yeah. I've known friends of mine that they do drink warm water, and when we're outside they don't have warm water, but they have lemon put in it. Not necessary?
No, you don't need lemon.
Nothing.
And you don't need room temperature. People, let me tell you what the fallacies are. Most people think lemon has to go in there and that'll help them lose weight. And they think room temperature. You know, no, it has to be heated, distilled water that's going to scrub out the large intestine and the small intestine. It's going to get rid of the toxin, the poison, the waste, the parasites.
Doesn't niacin do that?
The metal.
What about niacin?
Well, niacin does it, but
niacin is great for the
ears.
See,
everybody wants to use chemicals that man make, and everybody wants to use products and stuff that's manufactured by man. Water is manufactured by God, and that's what you were born in, and that's what you came in, was water.
Yeah, right.
It wasn't no lemon in the water. It wasn't no niacin in the water. Wasn't
well, I did
any
ask
tea.
My mother, I said, hey, Mom, could you put a slice of lemon in there? She said she couldn't quite do that.
Well, this is the deal. The mom ate from the dirt of the earth.
Yeah,
she did eat lemons, but guess what? The lemons, the vitamins from the lemon, the vitamin C, came into the water, but through the mom's...
Through her tragical system.
Right.
But I want to get back to this this book, to Matrix 4. And when is all this going to happen? And when is all this come? Because you've written the book.
Yeah, I've written the book. I've written the shooting script already.
The shooting script?
Yes, it's been done.
To the book.
The movie poster. The movie poster is done. The
any written
script.
Any written script for the movie? Anything taken out that you didn't want taken out, or did you just write it yourself?
I wrote everything myself.
Okay, because sometimes you have a book and then it goes to a film and they take things out and you say, well,
No. I'm doing it and producing it myself, so that way it will
be what
flow.
It'll be what you had in your mind and what you put to pen to paper.
Well. Everybody's reading it, so they already know what the pen to paper is.
Yes.
But
yes.
I just think that with the special effects and the graphics, since they're so different, so new, because I'm talking about virtual reality, I'm talking about virtual penal system, I'm talking about the virtual skateboards and the microchips and
all this
new stuff
such
that's
a
coming.
World
yeah, and the virtual companies.
Such a different
yes.
world we're living in.
Yes.
To when I was born, and well, not, but when I was capable of life, And now it is so different, but I love different. See, I'm all in for different. I just love it. I work on this. I eat it up. Matrix 5.
Well, wait a minute. Matrix 4 is going to be more incredible because of the special effects and graphics, I think, because of the animation, that it'll be able to capture the special effects and graphics, because filming it live would have cost a lot of money.
Well, come to it live now anyway.
Anywhere from $150 to $200 million, and Warner Brothers offered me $30 million for the shooting script.
Really?
That's right.
$30 million.
Yeah, but listen to me. They offered me $30 million for the shooting script. I did not take it because what I've created is going to make billions of dollars, like it did the first Matrix and Terminator is made anywhere from $35 billion to $100 billion. Yeah. So when you got original work. That's what original work does.
This is original work.
That's right.
This is yours.
The other is mine too.
They're all yours.
And the copyrights.
They're all hers. And that must be one of the greatest feelings out there, that you've actually done something and you own it.
I own it by copyrights.
By copyrights.
I was at the 92nd Academy Awards, the Oscars. The Matrix won 4 Oscars, the first Matrix. And it's something that should be celebrated.
Absolutely.
Because of the original work.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying?
Yes, I know exactly.
Original characters, graphics, special effects.
So when is this coming out? When do you feel that this is all going to start?
The animation should be coming out like 2022. Yes.
I know it sounds a little far away, but it's not really. But this is how long things take to do. This is how long they take. Matrix 5 probably is up here somewhere. You're thinking about it somewhere along the line, but at the moment you're definitely on number 4.
Well, this is the deal. Since I have a book on Matrix 4, a lot of time you film different parts that you don't use, and that will be the beginning of Matrix 5. Yeah.
So I knew she already had it going. She already had it thinking. She already had it. Going down that road.
You always got to think about it.
You must be very proud of yourself, of what you've done, but you've also taken advantage of what God actually gave you with this, what you see ahead and what you see is happening. You actually didn't sit back and not use it. You actually used it. My producer's telling me that I have 2 minutes. So we have only 2 minutes. How can anybody reach you and get hold of you? Because this woman is amazing. I could sit and talk to you all day long.
Thank you. You're
fascinating to me. Because you've got so many things out of the ordinary that you bring forward to the front.
Yes.
Of what's going on, sort of now, of what's happening. So everybody out there, don't be too scared and don't be too worried. Just try to do your best you can. I know the COVID-19 is bothering all of us, but I've had a lot of people on today that are actually using it, and they've had advantages of it by trying to work around it and in it.
Yes.
And that's what you've done. Well, I don't think this COVID makes any difference to you, because you work anyway. This is what you do. You're not on stage performing. She's making movies.
She's making movies. And I have some fabulous movie posters and books, and everybody knows my website, matrixterminator.com. Matrixterminator.com. Get the Matrix 4 book. It's on Amazon, on demand, Walmart, Barnes & Noble, everywhere. It's selling on
demand.
And
it's also, if you want to get it, you can go to Vegas Live with Ninon. I'll get my little plug in there.
Oh, yes, yes.
We will publicize, obviously, because this woman, I just love interviewing her. You're just amazing, because you are actually of the times and ahead.
Yes.
This is what's going on now, but she also sees in the distance what is happening and how it's all going. And it's just, I love every minute of it. I hope I've got enough time in my years left, because I'm a bit old. But I'm only old in age. I'm not old in mind at all. No,
right.
I'm not old in mind at all. No. It's because of all the tea I drink, all the hot water and all the tea I drink.
That's
anyway,
right.
Thank you so much.
You're
Sophia,
welcome.
She's absolutely, Sophia Stewart, don't forget that name. Look her up, absolutely amazing. But I want to thank all of you, because if it wasn't for all of you out there, I would not have a show. This young lady has been publicizing her last interview all over the place, and everybody apparently likes my interviewing, so...
Touché. Oh, yes.
Love it. Thank you. And we'll be back next week with more guests, more people, and more things to learn about. Don't let the COVID-19 get you down. Use it like anything. Use it all. Thank you all for watching Vegas Live with Ninon. Don't forget to subscribe. Go to YouTube and subscribe. I'll be back next week. Take care. If you enjoyed the last show we just did and all the other shows, don't forget to subscribe Vegas Live with Ninon on YouTube. We've got plenty more coming up and our guests are amazing. So don't forget to subscribe. We'll be right back. Vegas Live with Ninon.